In this video, I'll show you how you can schedule your exams by using the Criterion Web Assessor website and also where you can find some mock exams. So the easiest way to do it is you go to Trailhead, and with the Trailhead you go to the lab credentials, and here you see all the different credentials. What you then can do is click Schedule Now. So I'm just going to go for the administrator one just as an example. What it then will do is it will divert you to the Criterion website. And here you then can log in and also set up your account. Now, this is not automatically generated, this account, so it's not the same login details as you use for your Trailhead. So if you have not created an account before, you have to create a new one. And how you do that is here on the right hand side, you see create a new web assessor login. Click on that. And that will open up your sign up page. What you see then here is, first of all, you need to create your account details, which is your basically your username and your password. What I would say to make it easy is, as username, as it needs to be an email address, use the same as what you use for your Trailhead. Also use that as your sign up email address, and you also have here at the bottom an email address associated with your Salesforce account. That then, what it does is it automatically links whatever you do on Criterion. So the moment you pass your exam, it will automatically link it to your Trailhead account. So I would use everywhere the same email address, because that makes it so much easier. You then have to type in all your personal information. So your name, your address details, things like postcode and country. And then finally here at the bottom, you have some additional information. If you're not working for a specific company, you can put in NA. You can also put in, if you want to, a different name or whatever you want to be on your certificate. But I would keep it simple and put it as your official name that you would like to see there. Maybe the same as that you use commonly, like on your LinkedIn profile. Here on the dropdown, you then need to say what you are, if you are an employee, a customer or a partner. So pick what is applicable. You can also do a verification opt-in, so that means that they can check if you have a verification, yes or no. And then finally, you also have your role, in what sector you are, if you're private or public. For most of you, it will be private, but only if you are in a government-related function will you pick up public. Once you've done that, you click Save. It will then send you an email to your email address, and then you need to verify your account. What I'm going to do is I'm going to temporarily pause the video because I'm going to log in because I've already created my account and I can then show you where you can find the different exams. So here we are on the Criterion website. You see here your home area. And as we are doing this now in October, you still see some information about COVID, which might have an impact in the type of exam sentence that are available. In some cases, you might not be able to go to an exam center, which means that you can't do on-site proctored. In that case, you do online proctored, which basically means you do it from home. If you want to see what kind of exams there are, if you click on the button Register for an exam here at the top, it will open up the area where you see all the different exams. So for example, if I click on Admin Exams, you see here the two different exams. Where you have your normal admin and your advanced admin. And if I then click on the plus, you then see the option between on-site and online. So make sure you pick the correct one. You can go for on-site first and see if there's anything on-site. And if there isn't anything, you can always change it to online. But once you book it, you either have an on-site one, which means you have to go there, or you have an online one, which means you do it from home. And here you have then all the other exams. Now, well, like I said, there are some official test exams and you find them here on your certified practice test. If I click there on the plus, at the moment there are two available. You have a Marketing Cloud Email Specialist practice test and an admin practice test. That basically means, like it says here, it's unproctored, so you can just book it. And you can sit the exam whenever you want to at the comfort of your home. So it will be completely online. You don't have to go anywhere. The moment you launch it, you will actually sit it. So be aware that when you book it, If you then immediately click launch, you will immediately have to go through that exam. And it's only a one go exam. So you can't pause it. You can't really say, I'll go back to it later. I've did something stupid. So make sure that you can book it now if you want to, or buy it now. And then maybe sit it in a couple of days when you're ready. I would definitely advise you to do it for either of those, to sit those practice tests, maybe a couple of days before you're planning to sit your exam, just to see how you're doing and how well you're scoring. The scores will be sent to your email address that you've used to sign up on, so then you can see how you've done and if you need some more studying or if you're ready to sit your exam. So this is where you can book your exams and also where you can see which exams there are. Once you booked, you can go to My Assessments, and I don't have any at the moment, and there you can see what you have scheduled, etc. So with that, we are at the end of this video. Good luck with your exams.